hostess with the hostess, sharing the good news that you can use as we talk community awareness and keep you in the know. I am Angela Woods, aka known as That Laurel Hill Girl. And today, y'all, my special guest is beautiful inside and out. I have the privilege of having with me Ms. Shawna Brown. Shawna is a shop owner of Kings and Queens Barber Salon, and I'm going to let her tell you more. But let's welcome her, y'all. Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you so much for coming in. And I'm kind of hitting you guys. I'm going to move for a second. We are live on the air, so just bear with me. This is called real life. How you feeling today?
Wonderful.
So tell us about yourself, about your shop, you know, what you do with your shop.
Okay, I am a glass cosmetologist, salon owner. We're located here in Rock Hill. Conveniently on at 1244 East Main Street, right beside Full Line, in the Full Line shop, so in the subway. And I love Rock Hill. It's very family oriented. Okay. And the service that we provide? Mm-hmm. We provide a variety of services at the salon, from braids, weaves, sew-ins, sister locks, relaxers, colors, a little bit of everything.
You do nails too.
Yes, we do. Surely do.
Well, we're about to get into it, you guys. This is gonna be really good. I'm super excited because I have the privilege of knowing her through my hair stylist. And now, do they call them stylists or hairdressers?
I would say hairdresser. That term is kind of dated.
Okay. I was wondering where I was with that, you know.
But that's kind of dated.
So that's how I met her. And I'm just so privileged to know. I'm like, wow. I think it's pretty awesome to be a shop owner. You know, big boss.
Yeah.
In charge.
Yes, well, I've been licensed since 1988.
Wow, girl, that's a long time. Ooh, that's good stuff.
Yes.
So you're seasoned. You're been with you. This is good stuff. Now, where did you attend your cosmetology school?
I attended my my education from Chester County Career Center in Chester, South Carolina.
Chester County, boom.
Yes, I'm a Cyclone. When I was coming through the ranks, you would attend, take some in classes your junior year, and then you would finish your senior year in classes.
So I asked them to. Okay. You know, I did see that one, you know, because that's my husband's hometown.
Okay.
And so I think that may have been the first school that I grew up. So I think it's pretty cool. Did they offer it? They still offer it, right?
They still offer it, yes. Okay. They still offer it. And actually, I had my cosmetology license before I graduated from high school.
Oh, man, that's strong.
Yeah.
That is deep. Okay, so you had the license before. Mm-hmm. So how long have you been in the business?
Ever since then.
Oh my God, that's over almost 30 years?
Yes, this year it's our 35th anniversary.
Wow, that's huge.
It doesn't seem like it does feel like 35 years.
It went by fast.
Yes. That's great. I just graduated a few years ago.
Except on some mornings when the cold air So how do you keep up with the recent trends? I mean, you never get enough.
You never stop learning. Every day you learn something new.
Okay.
Every day. You should always want to invest in yourself. I myself can take continuing education classes.
Okay.
Always learning is education everywhere. And attending the seminars, you know, the air shows.
Okay.
Yes, you always.
So you go to those big ones in Atlanta?
Yes.
Is that Bronx?
The Bronx, yes.
Okay, that's nice.
That's
like a party.
Yes, that is something to see. So many different, so many different styles and the creativity.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
And so if people are doing aesthetics, they're there too, right?
Yes.
So if you do nails, they're there. Okay. Because someone was trying to tell me, and I knew she was a nail tech, and I was like, what you going to the nail shop? But it's all the same family.
It's all combined.
to y'all. I'm learning some things today. And with that being said, I want you to tell us about your sister Locs, because not too many people do that.
Yes.
And so that's a whole nother in itself,
yes,
right?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Sister Locs is, oh gosh, is total freedom for an individual. I would say it's a special technique that, again, you have to receive a training in. Mm-hmm. And it just gives us, because they are smaller, they're more versatile, so you're apt to have different types of styles, mm-hmm, versus the traditional locks, which are a little bit larger in size.
Right. Mm-hmm. Right. Does it take a long time?
It can, yes. It can vary.
Okay.
Yes.
Per person,
yes,
right?
Per person, yes. Okay. Yes. Okay. Yes. Mine was 2 days.
For real? They look great, though.
Thank you.
They look really good. And so, and the maintenance on you good.
Oh, man. I'm like an in heaven walking on earth. I don't have to worry, you know, products and this, that. I'm good. I'm free.
Yeah. Well, see,
thank you, Lord.
Yeah. See, Kim Crossley. My hairdresser is Kim. Kimberly Erby. Hey, Kim.
Hi, Kim.
Don't get upset, Kim. It was a surprise. So, she gets on me all the time because I keep my pent up.
Uh-huh.
I'm dealing with some, you know, my age issues.
Yes.
That's all I can say, ladies.
Yes.
You don't know about them hot flashes. But I tell you, I love how you're set up too in your shop, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So now, we're gonna dive into some nitty gritty.
Okay.
I'm not gonna necessarily call it a headache, but how was it when dealing with state board?
State board, it hasn't been any challenges. As long as you continue on the daily, maintain the rules and regulations, you don't have any problems with state board. That's as for reference to sanitation, mm-hmm, cleanliness, hygiene, your products in order,
yeah,
different things. They give us a guideline to follow. So, following those guidelines on a daily basis, then there's no issue when they, mm-hmm, appear, because they can appear at any time.
Yeah,
there's no issue when they stop by to inspect, and you want to, that's protecting us as stylists as well as our clients.
Right.
So, yeah.
Yeah, and each one of your girls have to do the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, mm-hmm, keeping their stations clean and all, mm-hmm, that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
How about your, I think every shop has a product guy.
Uh-huh.
What happens when he no longer has your stuff?
Ooh, what happens when? Well, that can be a challenge. So whenever that does happen, it's just trying to, a challenge to find someone else that may supply the product that we need. Because we have to have products for our clients.
Yeah.
So important.
But don't you hate that? I hate when that happens. Because it seems like when you find that perfect lipstick,
yes,
they discontinue it. Like,
yes.
It takes about 10 more years to find another.
Like, no. So when that learning curve is, you have to stock, prepare ahead.
That's true.
Yeah.
And I have been noticing some other ladies on YouTube.
Yes, yes.
Honey, when they go by, they buy 2 and 4.
Yes.
At one time with those concealers and,
yes,
stuff. So, okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I'm going to do better. That's all I'm going to say. I'm going to do better. So is it hard to run a booth around a salon?
No, I wouldn't say hard. It's just, you know, each salon owner has that, that opportunity where they can decide what works best for them. Whether it's commission based or whether it's booth rental. And with booth rental, that owner may, you know, decide on the fee that they'll charge, whether weekly for that area, that space. And then the owner and the stylist will determine on how the transaction will occur. So I wouldn't say hard, it's just that owner has to decide what's best for them, whether it's commission based or,
okay,
booth, because you have those options.
Oh, okay.
Booth rental.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I love how, you know, you've helped, it seems like, well, from my visit to the shop, I, mm-hmm, see some newcomers,
uh-huh,
and fresh out of school.
Uh-huh. Yes.
I love the,
yes,
fact that you take a chance.
Yes, yes. And the reason for that is that I know that once I was in that position,
okay,
as well,
mm-hmm,
you know, graduating Like, where do I go? Where do I decide? And I want everyone to come in feeling welcomed.
Yeah.
And if they need anything, have any questions, we're there as a team to help.
Yeah. And all of them, you have a real diverse group. Because I think you have one that she does a lot of locks.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of the guys come off this in.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes.
And you have, does she have your nail technician in there?
Not at this moment. No.
Okay. It's okay, honey. She got it going all the time. I want her to know. Right the shop line now. We're going back to it. Okay.
Don't get to this.
That's right. So if you had to help someone or advise them on opening a shop, what are the top maybe three or five things that's most important for opening a shop?
I would say they would need to prepare. They would need to write their vision and make it plain.
You better stay right there, girl. Hallelujah. I do it every day, sis, right?
Write the vision and make it plain.
It's true. So true.
Because without a vision, what happens?
Get past, honey. Snow and boy. That's right.
They have to write a vision, make it plain. Their thoughts that they have here, they need to write it down.
Mm-hmm.
They need to make sure they have a business plan in place.
That's right.
Their LLC, the distributors, where they're going to buy their products from.
Ooh, that's deep.
Their insurance. Or the salon.
Yeah, we can't forget about no insurance, y'all.
Insurance on your car. You know, if they have to, and then we also, and they'll be able to connect with someone that's already seasoned that will guide them.
Right. Because
that's good. Starting fresh, you know, everyone needs someone.
Yeah.
Everyone needs someone.
That's
and
right.
Trying to start and do it on your own, I'm not saying that you can't, but it helps. Because God created us here to help each other.
That's right.
And we can't do it alone because He doesn't want us to do it alone.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what I would suggest, that they try to write their vision, make it plain, pray about it, write their vision, make it plain, search for a mentor to guide them on this season and with the area of direction that they want to go.
Mm-hmm. That's good. Mm-hmm. Now, what are the three things to be a successful salon? Amen. Y'all better get that word today.
Keep him first. Was he going to him, having that communication with him, that relationship with him, he will guide us. It's all things.
That's right.
He wants us to talk to him.
Yes, he does.
We're nothing without him. Let me get back to the salon. But we're nothing without him.
No.
We go to him.
Yeah,
in our quiet place.
Yeah.
And ask him, Father God, guide me. What should I do? What should I not do?
That's right.
And he will tell you.
Yes, he will. Just be quiet and listen. Yeah. Whenever I didn't have that relationship with God, I couldn't hear what he was saying. But when you get there, you'd be like, wow, he's been talking this whole time.
Like,
I just wasn't listening. But yeah, he makes it clear too.
He makes it so clear.
Yeah. If he has to say it over and over again, he'll make it clear.
A soft, gentle voice.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. See, that's good stuff. Now, how are you able to have like a work-life balance? Because you do a lot.
Again, it's a challenge. I'm not saying that it's, you know, easy. Mm-hmm. But again, taking that time to fall back. Self-care is so important.
Yeah, true.
Self-care. So, because you can do, and then you're running on fumes.
Mm-hmm.
Self-care. Having that balance, talking and praying with God, communing with Him.
Mm-hmm.
Structure. I'm a structure type person.
Yeah.
Writing it down.
Yeah.
Having a schedule, time management is very
important. Sure. Yeah, that, you know, I'm learning to do better with blocking off time.
Yes.
You know, yeah, really. Because, and even with like paper. Oh my God, I'm not being obsessive with paper. My husband is.
Okay.
And so I'm kind of like showing him that, okay, if it's nothing but just take 5 minutes and say, I'm going to tackle this stack right here.
Yes, yes.
And you'll be so surprised at what you can do. You'll be like, what? That's just like that.
That is so true.
So true. But you're right about that. Time management. All right. Self-care, you guys.
Self-care, time management.
So you still go on vacation?
Okay.
That's so hard, sis.
Yes.
You may
have to.
You have to. Yeah.
You have to.
Because we do the same thing. You know, we know when to turn it off.
Yes. And it's okay.
Yeah.
Because I'm telling you. long. If not, you'll have clients and people reaching out to you
24/7.
They might be like, what, really? And you know, some, you just have to have those guidelines and that balance. You have to.
Structure.
I love that.
I love that. Now, if you had to, or how should I say it? What would you say if you had known sooner? What would you do different? Would you do anything different? Or if you had to do it all again?
I would search for a mentor.
Okay.
If I had to do things differently. My experience was a daily trial where I learned as you go.
Yeah.
Kind of thing.
Okay.
I feel like if I had a mentor, someone that was genuine to guide me, that would.
Good word,
genuine.
Because when people are genuine, they'll take you on through the process.
Yes.
When people are not genuine, they'll pick you up, put you down.
Yes.
And you might not see them for another 4 or 5 months.
Yes.
You still waiting on them.
Yes, someone that's genuine. Yes.
That's
if
good.
I had to do things and do over.
That's good. Yeah. Well, I mean, I know because you've been in the business so long, you know, she don't plan on getting going anywhere soon, you guys, okay? But she wears a lot of hats, and, you know, we're going to bring her back because I want her to talk about that in another section and and just give us some more life to speak life into us. But how can they find you? You know, what are your social media platforms?
Okay, social media platforms on Facebook would be Kings and Queens Barber Salon on Facebook. And then I have my Brown1Shawna Instagram. Mm-hmm. And then I also have my Shawna Brown Facebook. So those are three different avenues.
Okay. And what is the shop number, phone number?
Shop number is 803-980-2911.
And give that address one more time.
The address is 1244 East Main Street, Rock Hill, South Carolina, located in the Food Line Shopping Center, same building as the Subway.
Yeah.
Everyone loves to eat fresh.
And I love the area that you're in too. Was that part of your marketing process when you thought of the
location? Is so important. Location, yeah. location.
That's right.
Because in the past, I've been in areas where the location was not ideal.
Mm-hmm.
Here where we're located now, we have the parking is there.
Yeah, convenient.
Yeah. Grocery store right there.
Yeah.
Different.
We get hungry, we can go to Bojangles,
yes.
Come back to the shop.
It's right there. You know, you have your Bojangles, Wendy's, McDonald's, Subway. We have a variety.
That's good stuff. Now, you have about how many stylists in your shop?
I have five other stylists, including myself.
So she has all hands on deck.
Yes.
And all the time.
Yes.
So this is beautiful. Well, I don't know.